Thank you, Daniela. It is time for the headliner presented by Miller Lite, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome to the headliner Mike Vernon, former Red Wing Stanley Cup champion, two-time Stanley Cup champion, and Conn Smythe winner for the Red Wings back in 1997. Mike, thanks for joining us. Really, really appreciate it.
No problem.
Let's go back to June 29th, 1994. You're traded to the Red Wings from Calgary. You basically spent your entire hockey career playing in Alberta, playing in your hometown of Calgary. I know you're in Portland a little bit and all that. Was it a bit of a culture shock? Because I remember talking to you where you were kind of ready maybe to leave the Flames organization at that point.
Oh, most definitely. I've, you know, just growing up here in Calgary, playing all my hockey, minor hockey, junior hockey, and then the pros. I just felt personally that it's a small city, Calgary. I think back in those days it was only about 600,000 people, so a lot of people either knew me or thought they knew me and things like this, and it just the pressure of the Canadian city. And like I recall one time during playoffs, we had a couple days off, and I just went to the golf course just to hit balls, you know, on the range, and people, oh, shouldn't you be practicing? Shouldn't you be doing this? Shouldn't you be, you know, it's just wherever I went, like it was just people in my ear and trying to talk. And you just wanted to, you know, you just wanted to get away and relax and just, you know, let your body recover and try to, you know, get your mind clear and get ready for the next game. But it was just, and it was no different than Patrick Waugh in Montreal. He was going through the same thing, and then he got traded. But yeah, it was time for me to leave. I had a good run in Calgary, and you know, we won a Stanley Cup and things like that. To land in Detroit, I enjoyed it there. I know it's a hockey town, the pressure, but I felt at peace there, and I just enjoyed my time there, and it was fun, and being paired up with Chris Osgood, who I got along with very well and still to this day do. So it was just a good, it was a good scenario for myself.
When you look at it, and you know, and obviously we both know Ozzy very, very well, you know, he still lives in the area. Can you talk about that relationship? Because Chris has always kind of paid respect to all the veteran goalies that he worked with. But when he talks about Vernie, he just lights up. I mean, did you, because you're in competition with each other, but you kind of know you're a veteran. You're there to mentor him too. But how come it was just such a great tandem? You two were great. You won the Jennings Trophy in 95-96. So together. So can you talk about that relationship a bit?
Well, we're both from Alberta and have that hockey mentality. And I think we have that mentality that we just do everything for the team. And it's a team game and things like that. And I think one of the first things he just said, did you want number 30? And I said, no, you can have it. I don't need to have number 30 because I wore number 30 for years in Calgary. And I said, no, I'm fine with changing my number. And I think that he respected that. And we got off to a good footing right off to the start, and we were supporting each other and things like that, and we just created this nice friendship, and there was no animosity, and we were very supportive of each other going through it all. So I even remember, like, the last year that I played, and Ozzy was playing very well during the season and things like that, and when Scotty made a decision later to maybe go with me in playoffs and things like that, and you know, Chris handled it very professionally, very well, very supportive. And, you know, I just knew that I had to hold up my end of the bargain. Both of us had to play well, or the other guy was going to get an opportunity. And what better situation for a hockey team to have is two goaltenders battling it out for, you know, for playing time. And, you know, I think that was a very good scenario to have. I know some teams like to just one goaltender and go with one goaltender, and nowadays it's so hard with all the injuries and things like that. And I just think that the two tandem goalie situation with an older guy and a younger guy worked very well, and both goalies were very capable of playing.
You know, it certainly did, and I, you know, Fox Sports Detroit is going to be showing the '97 playoffs on the day that this airs on November 5th on Thursday. They'll show Game One of the 1997 Stanley Cup Finals. But I want to go back because this is almost forgotten. March 26, 1997, a day that will live forever in Red Wing lore. Not only do you get your 300th career victory, but you score a unanimous decision against your old, I don't know, nemesis or not, Patrick Waugh. Going into that game, Mike, yeah, I mean, you guys had a, I don't know if Detroit fans were aware of this. You guys go back quite a ways, and I'm kind of curious, did you see March 26 coming? What was going through your mind? I don't know how many times Ozzy talks about his fight with Waugh all the time. I haven't really heard you kind of, you know, go on about it, but what was that whole atmosphere like that night?
Well, it from a goaltending standpoint, it wasn't one of my better outings. Let me put it to you that way, because I did not play well that night. And it was ironic that the two guys that started the fight was Larionov and Forsberg at the blue line. They start this the brawl basically, and then it just kind of then Darren McCarty went after Claude Lemieux that we've had, you know, he a few years ago he hit Chris Draper and where he broke his jaw and things like that from behind when he was going off to the bench. So that kind of created it, and then Patrick Waugh leaves the net and I'm like, okay, if he leaves I gotta leave type thing, and I'm like, oh, for crying out loud. So we he came out and I, you know, and him and Shanahan were mixed up, and then Adam Foote, I got a hold of Adam Foote's arm and he's looking at me and he goes, get out of here type thing. And then I don't know how it happened. Then Patrick Waugh kind of jumped on me from kind of behind a bit. And then we just kind of tussled, and I got lucky with one of the punches that I caught him with a left over the eye. And I know that the Red Wing fans and things like that love the Bobby Probert and Joey Kosher in the days with all the fighting. And once they saw blood, they declared victory for Vernon, I guess, type thing. And no, but it just, that was just the competitiveness in all of us that stepped up. And, you know, I don't know whoever won or lost or whatever, but if that whole scenario basically solidified our team and our team and united us, that we were all for one another. And it just grew from there. And then they went on and won many more Stanley Cups. And they had the great tradition. They were good there for well over 20 years and things like that. So it was a great time to be part of all of that. And, you know, that's just one of the great memories that I have of Detroit. And, I remember Ozzy, because I thought for sure I'd get kicked out of the game because I left the crease. I got in a fight. I should have been ejected from the game. And I'm sitting in my stall, and Ozzy comes up. They want you back in the net. And I go, well, I have to have been kicked out. You go in. And he says, no, you have to go back in. And I'm like, are you kidding? So I go back in, and I think we were losing the game at like 5-3 or something. And
right.
You know what? I don't, for some reason, the team came back and won that game. Like, I don't even think they got another shot on me the rest of the game. The guys just came out and played, and we won that game. And lo and behold, they come up to me and they go, well, that was your 300 victory. I didn't even know it was my 300 victory. Even people around Calgary here talk about it, and the kids and things like that. And I think I'm more known for the fight with Patrick Waugh than I am winning two Stanley Cups or even a Conn Smythe trophy.
Yeah, it's funny how things, you know, how people process things and what is a vivid memory. I mean, it was an excellent moment in Red Wing history, and I agree with you. That really did solidify the Red Wings and got them over that hump. Let's go to the 97 playoffs. You know, you you know, you beat Colorado in the Western Conference Final. Then you play Philadelphia, the Legion of Doom. You're the starting goaltender. Ozzie started most of the season or was kind of number one there for a while, but then Scotty comes up to you and says, you're starting the playoffs. Were you surprised that you got the nod in net?
I was a little surprised. And when Scotty told me to, you know, I'm going with you in playoffs and get yourself ready, because he told me about a month before playoffs, and he said, you're going to start playing a lot more. And it and how I played from there on in really determined if I was going to probably play in playoffs. But he was getting me ready to go, and I was well rested. I was working hard at practice and keeping myself in good shape and stuff like that. And I was, you know, I was just thankful to get that opportunity again to prove myself, to prove that I can still play in the NHL and get an opportunity like that. So I was definitely very thankful, and obviously I took advantage of it. But, you know, I was fortunate enough to get myself on a roll. When you're on a roll a bit, you know, you can get in there for a couple months, and that's what happened with me and the team. We just, like I said, we gelled together. We had a goal, and we never wavered from that goal, any of us. And we were a very focused hockey team.
You win the Conn Smythe Trophy, MVP of the playoffs, 16-4, goals against a 1.76, save percentage 927. You get a shutout. Shutout Colorado 6-0 in the Western Conference Final. But I am curious, Mike, did a fan throw a cigar at you right at the end of the game? I mean, you have a cigar, and no other Red Wing does. I mean, that picture, it's kind of a classic moment again in Detroit. Where did the cigar come from?
I don't know if someone had read an article, but I didn't mind having the odd cigar. And I don't know, some fan threw it at me, and I grabbed it, and I'm like, yeah, this is awesome. And I don't know who the fan was. To this day, I have no idea who the fan was.
Well, hopefully they're watching, and maybe you two can connect. Winning that 97, the Stanley Cup, 42-year drought, I can remember years ago, it was at, you know, Matthew Dandino's birthday party. You and I were sitting together. I don't know how that happened to happen. And I remember telling you, because you had won the cup with Calgary in 89, your hometown. I said, Mike, trust me, if you guys win this cup, this town is going to explode. With that said, that whole experience, that whole 97, how can you sum that up? What does that mean to Mike Vernon and his career to be a Stanley Cup champion with the Detroit Red Wings?
Well, I think it sums up my career. I never gave up, and I had 10 years in between winning a cup in Calgary and winning a cup in Detroit. And when you're an NHL player or goaltender, you have to prove yourself every day. And you know, and I took pride in it. It just self-rewarding for myself to know that I had a good career in the National Hockey League and put up some decent numbers. And I'm just personally proud of what I accomplished. And if the Hall of Fame recognizes that, great. If not, I know that I can live with myself. And I met some great people along the way. And I just have some great fond memories. My kids always ask me you should write a book, and people say you should write a book, but I don't think I'll ever write a book, but I have some great memories. I have some great stories to tell and things like that. And it's something that I dreamed of this when I was a kid. So my dream came true, and it was, it's an outstanding life that I had in a career.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, I'm a bit of a dreamer myself. And my dream is that you and Ozzie go into the Hall of Fame together, same ceremony. That would be completely wild. I hope it happens. You never know. And I'm still going to hold out hope. But, I don't say this very often, being a native Detroiter, being a lifelong Red Wing fan, to have a guy like you wear the red and white, to wear that winged wheel, It doesn't get much better than you, Mike Vernon. Thank you very, very much for joining us here on The Headliner. I really appreciate it. And we'll talk very, very soon. Thank you, Mike.
Great. Thanks, Art, and appreciate everything. And hi, Michigan.
All right. That'll do it for this edition of The Headliner presented by Miller Lite. Miller Lite, the original light beer. It's only 96 calories. It tastes delicious, and it is available for delivery. Daniela, back to you.